Hey, good morning everyone. My name is Vipin Kumar and in this video we are going to set up Kubernetes cluster 1.19 on CentOS 8 machine. My infrastructure looks like this. I have three machines, one for master and two for worker machine. I am using CentOS 8. This is the IP address for master machine and this is the host name for master machine. This is the IP address for worker machine 1 and this is the host name. This is the IP address for worker machine 2 and this is the host name. First step is make sure that you have DNS entry for all three machines in etc host file. On all three machines, if you are not using a proper DNS server, this is required to communicate with each other. Now go ahead and update the yum repository. Mine is up to date. It can take some time for you. Now we require to fine-tune some network setting for the Kubernetes, IP table of each Kubernetes machine should access the bridge traffic. For that, br_netfilter module should be enabled on all three machines. You can verify if it is running or not by the grep command. It is not running. Let's call this module. Now, if you grab again this module, now you can see here this module has been loaded. Go ahead and enable this module on rest of two machines. This module is successfully loaded on all three machines. Also, you require to set this value is 1 in your syscontrol config file. Let's edit this file and enabled it. Go ahead and apply this change on rest of two machines. Now we require to set up a runtime for the Kubernetes environment and we are going to use a Docker runtime for our Kubernetes environment. Follow these steps on all three machines to install the Docker runtime. Docker installation has been completed. Now let's check out the Docker version. We are using the Docker engine version 19. Now our network is ready, our container runtime is ready. Now we are ready to install Kubernetes components. Let's go ahead and create or update Kubernetes repository. Before installing and starting the Kubernetes components, we also require to disable SCLinux. This is required by the containers to access the file system on the host machine. Follow the steps to disable SCLinux on all three machines. Now we are ready to install kubeadm, kubectl and kubelets. Install all these components on all three machines. Kubeadm, kubelets and kubectl has been installed. We also required to disable swap file on all three machines. Let's enable. And now start it. Now we are ready to initialize the Kubernetes cluster. If your master machine has more than one virtual Ethernet card like mine, I am using the Vagrant box. This is ETH0 and this is ETH1. This is not routable IP address. This is loopback IP address. If you initiate your Kubernetes cluster on ETH0, then your Kubernetes API is not reachable. In this case, you are going to initialize your Kubernetes on routable IP address. In my condition, I am going to initialize my Kubernetes cluster on this IP address. Let's go ahead and initialize the Kubernetes cluster. My Kubernetes API server is going to access on this IP address. Along with, I am also providing the CIDR for the port network. This is recommended IP range from Celico CNI. I am using the Celico CNI for the port networking. There are many CNI projects available like Panel, but Celico is more powerful and stable CNI for the Kubernetes cluster. Let's go ahead and initialize your Kubernetes cluster. It is going to take some time to pull the image from container registry. Our Kubernetes cluster is ready. Copy the below token. This token is used by other node to join the Kubernetes cluster. Also, let's prepare kubectl to communicate with Kubernetes cluster. We are all set to connect our Kubernetes cluster. Let's pull down the list of the pod and their status. You can see here DNS pod is not ready or they are pending. They will not be run until unless network pod is running. Let's go ahead and set up the Celico network CNI. To set up the Celico CNI or network, I am going to use a operators. You can use the manifest deployment, but operators is easy to maintain, delete or update Celico network. Now let's create the Celico resources. These steps only required on master machine. Now let's pull down again pod list and their status report. Now you can see here the Celico ports are getting ready. Our code DNS port will get also ready because they are pending on Celico CNI network. Now let's pull down again pod. Yes, Celico pod is running along with DNS pod. We all set. Let's pull down the report of the node in a cluster. Yes, at this moment only master machine in a cluster. Let's add worker machine also in the cluster. To add worker machine in a Kubernetes cluster, you have to run a Kubernetes join command with a token. Let me run this command on second node also. Both the machine should be ready in a few minutes. Yes, both the machine successfully added into the cluster. Let's verify. It is not ready yet. Let's pull down the list of the pod. Yes, some of the pods are getting ready for the nodes like Celico, Kubeproxy, etc. Machine should be ready in a few minutes. Once all the ports are up and online, let's check once again if the pod is ready or not. Yes, ports are running on all the nodes. Let's verify the node status in a cluster. Yes, we all set. All three machines are ready in the cluster to take a load. So that is a complete step-by-step instruction how to set up a latest and stable Kubernetes 1.19 version. In next video, I'm going to set up a ingress controller on this latest and updated Kubernetes version. Since then, goodbye, have a nice day, and thanks for watching.